Michael, you just said, though, that it could very well make it harder for you to die from COVID. Isn't that reason enough?
Well, I think you're making a good argument to get the vaccine, but I didn't realize we were debating whether or not people should get the vaccine. I think that's a completely separate issue. The question is, does the government have the right to institute these kinds of mandates? And I think the legal grounding is pretty shaky. But two, is there a public health benefit to getting that vaccine? And again, I'm just relying on the data here from the CDC that came out at the end of July on the rates of transmission among vaccinated people. But there are reasons not to get vaccinated as well. UC Davis had a study come out not that long ago which showed that for certain young men, they actually face greater risk from the vaccine than they do of dying from the virus. We know that young women in particular have contracted blood clots from the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. That's why they paused the vaccine. We know that there are rates of myocarditis and pericarditis in people with the mRNA vaccines. We know that the vaccines have caused, again, in rare cases, nerve damage. And we know that people have religious objections to it as well, because all of the vaccines for coronavirus were at least developed, if not also produced, with fetal stem cells. So I just think there are a lot of arguments for prudence here. And also, let's not forget, the infection fatality rate from coronavirus is extraordinarily low. For people under 65, the infection fatality rate is less than half a percentage point. So if you're looking at, for all of these people, 99.5% are going to survive it. And for young people in particular, it's 99.997 or 99.999%. I just don't see where the urgency is for such an extraordinary draconian mandate.
Brian, no,
the craziest thing here is this is being said as if we haven't, again, just lost 700,000 people. Try telling the families of those 700,000 victims that we just that it's not important enough to impose any draconian measures. You know, this is going to be
this is going to be the average age of a COVID death in the United States.
I'm not sure. I don't have that on me.
So the average age of a COVID death in the United States is north of 80. The average age of a COVID death in the United States is higher than the average life expectancy in the United States. So I'm not saying that we don't need to protect grandma. We should, but grandma can go get the vaccine, and that vaccine is going to protect her from hospitalization and death. It's actually not going to provide an additional public health advantage.